A civilian casualty is flattered to have been mistaken for a Hamas leader. The entirety of a man's personal data is protected by a reference to the third season of The West Wing. And an asexually reproduced sea sponge is worried she's turning into herself. This news summary is best enjoyed in a state of leisurely repose, so sit back, relax, and let the waves of condensed news gently lap at your brain. This is the Onion Week in Review. In light of reports this week of a Russian crime ring stealing 1.2 billion username and password combinations from internet users, experts from top security firms across the country reportedly advised Americans to refrain from clicking on anything at all. The nation's top security specialists warned individuals to actively avoid any scrolling or swiping on the internet, and further urged Americans, as an added precaution, to steer clear of buttons, keyboards, and computer screens altogether. Hoping to foster a lifelong connection to the airline, Delta announced the launch of its official alumni magazine, Flown, this week, a quarterly publication for people who have been passengers with the airline at some point in the past. A press release from Delta confirmed that the magazine will feature obituaries, wedding announcements, and profiles of prominent flyers that celebrate the shared experiences and interests of the airline's 900 million alumni.
I think it's a nice thing for Delta to do. I mean, it's always interesting to just skim through an issue, see what the old boarding group's up to. It kind of makes me nostalgic for the few hours back when I was on that flight to Tampa. Simpler days.
In an effort to minimize the abuse of government assistance programs, a new nationwide law enacted this week requires welfare recipients to submit samples of their sweat to federal officials to prove how hard they are looking for a job.
By sending in a vial of their sweat, individuals receiving welfare and other state-sponsored benefits can prove to us that they're truly earning their checks and not taking advantage of the system. If you're out there looking diligently, drenching yourself in hard-earned sweat, then there should be nothing for you to worry about.
And in this week's opinion pages, a man notes that if the Founding Fathers were alive today, they'd be too fascinated by a garbage disposal to do anything. In other news, an employer botches a job interview. A date's flaws are coming at a woman faster than she can rationalize them, and a going out of business sign thanks a neighborhood for 3 months of no support whatsoever. Whether or not this video news summary eased the pain of your existence, you can now take solace in the fact that you're a few minutes closer to departing this meaningless world. For more, keep checking theonion.com.